Hello, my friends. Welcome once again to Sunday School. Please pray with me. Dear God, please be with us. Hear our words, watch our actions, and we pray that you find them most pleasing in your sight. Amen. I'm here in the outdoor chapel known as Galloway Chapel on our church campus. And you might be wondering, why did I come out here today? And today's lesson comes from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 1, verses 21 to 28. And so far in this fast-moving story of Jesus' ministry as told by Mark, we found Jesus coming to John the Baptist, his cousin, to be baptized in the River Jordan. And then he goes immediately out into the wilderness where he is fasting and praying for 40 days. And then he emerges from this time of prayer and contemplation. Remember, contemplation is when we're thinking about things, ready to begin his ministry among the people. And the first thing he does is call the disciples, Simon, Andrew, James, and John, which we talked about just last Sunday. And now today we're gonna meet Jesus as he is being a healer of someone who is being troubled, feel troubled, that is hurting in a real way. And so I want you to listen to this story, my friends, and I hope that your parents are watching it with you, or if you are watching this alone, that then you will go and find your parents and have a conversation about how can we spread and share God's love with everyone. And so I chose to come out here in the outdoor chapel because sometimes we seem to think that, you know, we can only talk about sharing God's love or talk about God when we're at church inside a building that has crosses and everything. But my friends, Jesus was teaching about God's love right where the people lived, right where the people traveled. And I thought Galloway Chapel being outdoors, we've got this coral wall. You can't see the entirety of the wooden cross, but you can see part of that beam. And we have benches out here made of wood, and we're just surrounded by nature. So I want you to think that we don't always have to be inside four walls, that God's Spirit lives within us, travels with us wherever we go. And if we remember, Jesus never was preaching in a building like we remember churches and temples, but he was out among the people. So listen carefully now to this little story that talks about Jesus' healing power and who enables him to do that. Listen. Well, Jesus, he continued to travel around Galilee, and he was teaching and healing, and his disciples, Simon, Andrew, James, and John, were traveling along with him, as did others who came to hear about Jesus and want to follow him around and also spread his love. They wanted to learn more about Jesus and about what Jesus was telling them and how Jesus was showing them what God's love was all about. So one day, Jesus and the disciples were in a town by the Sea of Galilee called Capernaum. And on the Sabbath day, that means the day of worship, the day of rest, the holy day for the Jews, they went to the synagogue in Capernaum. And because Jesus was a guest, he was invited to read the scriptures. Now, after reading, Jesus taught the people about what had just been read to them. And the people, wow, they were so surprised because Jesus taught like the people who had spent all of their time studying the scriptures. I want you to remember that. They said they were surprised because Jesus was speaking like someone who had been studying the scriptures for many, many years. Or in our case, We think about the pastors who have gone off to seminary, a type of college where they've been studying. And so you expect them to be able to know the scriptures. Well, the people, they were surprised. They didn't expect this from Jesus because they thought of Jesus as one of them. He was the people. He was the carpenter's son. So they were a little surprised by Jesus's teaching. And they said, but they could see that Jesus was like them. And they were wondering, like, where does he get this authority? That means who said that he could do this? So as Jesus was teaching, there was some loud noise that came along and it was disturbing everyone. They were trying to hear what Jesus said and there was this loud noise going on and the noise was questioning Jesus. And it said, what are you doing here? I know you. You are the Holy One. What do you want from us? Just leave us alone. Well, everyone, they looked at the person who was shouting and then they looked at Jesus. Well, Jesus, he looked straight into the eyes of this man who was shouting and he looked. He did not take his eyes off of him. And Jesus could see that the man was in pain and he was angry about something. Jesus didn't know where the pain and the anger was coming from. And he just simply looked the man straight in the eye and he said, be silent, come out of him. Wow. Jesus was not talking to the man, he was talking to the pain and the anger that was inside of this man. Then the man, he began to shake and he was shaking very hard and he screamed and he fell down to the ground. Jesus did not take his eye off that man. He continued to look at him and the people were beginning to wonder what's going on. And then the man became very quiet. The pain and the anger were gone. Well, the people in the synagogue, they couldn't believe what they had seen. And they went, wow, what is this? How did Jesus do that? Where does Jesus get this power and authority? These were all very good questions, my friends. It was clear to everybody in that moment that Jesus was no ordinary teacher. He was no ordinary healer. Jesus spoke and acted with an amazing power, a power that came from God. This was a power of love. This was a power of caring. This was a power that showed people who felt alone and hurt that they mattered, that somebody cared, that somebody was watching them, that someone was Jesus. Well, this power and authority brought the people closer and closer to God and to one another. And so, when the crowd left, they were telling other people all about Jesus, what happened, how he cured, how he helped heal that man that day, how he took away the pain and the hurt and the anger inside. So wherever Jesus went after that, there were people gathering all from the countrysides, from everywhere, to come to hear what Jesus had to say. Jesus was attracting people just like magnets to metal. Wow. What a story. And you're probably thinking, well, what does this all mean, Mrs. Bird? How can we help? What it means, my friends, simply this, that God's love is inside each and every one of us. And people that we meet, they may have some pain, they have some hurt, they may be mad, but you know what? You can say something kind to them. You could share your lunch. You could read a story. You could invite them to come and play with you. Or you could just simply, as Jesus did, look them straight in the eye and say, without hesitation and fully believing, God loves you. Yes, my friend, God loves you, God loves me, and God wants us to share this love, this living love of God with everyone we meet. So that's what I want you to do this week, friends. When you find someone who's feeling sad or sitting alone, you don't have to touch them. You don't even have to say anything. You can just look at them lovingly in the eyes and be thinking in the deepest part of your heart, God loves you, and let that love shine through your eyes. And remember, until next time, let your light shine. Shine wherever you go, spreading God's love. Amen.